One of the most popular show on Netflix right now is Tiger King. The whole world is talking about it. They're going crazy about the show. It's so amazing, so beautiful, so they say. So guys, have you seen Tiger King? If you have, make sure you tell me down below and give me your honest opinion about it. So right here, right now, we get to check out the honest trailer. So let's see what they have to say about Tiger King. So guys, I want to thank you so much for stopping by. The name is Perp the Mayor. If you're new here, please make sure you look around if you like what you see. Don't forget to subscribe down below, share with your friends, show some love, and let's check out the honest trailers for Tiger King. Let's go.
In a world where the quarantine masses cry out for entertainment, Netflix will save us with the perfect distraction for our troubled times. Even though it's dumb luck we got stuck at home now instead of last month, or we'd all be bonding over how dumb the Goop Lab is.
We're coming up against some limitations of the matter-to-matter kind of healing, where you do physical to work on the physical.
Kill me. Tiger King. Experience the ultimate example of timing is everything in this true crime doc that replaces all your fear, boredom, and isolation with a group of zookeepers who will shock, delight, and confuse you with every other sentence.
They burned up 7 of my crocodiles.
I had bought a lemur with bogus paperwork.
I once saw a guy get his finger bit off by a bear outside my office window.
I'd like to introduce my wife, but my husband's at home feeding my brand new baby kangaroo.
In this series, that's one part Coen Brothers crime story.
Would you actually grind your husband up, feed him to the tiger so there's no evidence?
And I guess that was your accomplice in the wood chipper.
One part Christopher Guest movie.
We got honey, we got barbecue sauce, skin cream, political condoms.
These are my personalized hand towels. These have been selling pretty well.
And one part snuff film.
And you say, oh man, this is a Ruger. You know a Ruger won't fire without a clip.
But since it is real, we have to grapple with the fact that we're all laughing at, if not outright celebrating, a bunch of broken people hurting each other and their animals.
And those cats trusted me, and so they could look me in the eye when they died.
Can we grapple with that after the pandemic? Or now I just want to hee-haw at some yahoos.
I saw a tiger, the tiger saw me.
He thinks he's people. Want to get into the exotic animal game? There's a few rules you gotta follow. 1, you gotta be a polygamist. Wait, what?
Joe asked me if Travis could be in a relationship with us too.
Dr. Intel has 4 or 5 wives. Him and Lauren Swing, they use the tigers to entice them in.
2, you gotta be extremely paranoid because everyone's out to get you.
He was already a paranoid person.
What do you carry that gun for?
People.
We put in security cameras, kept guns by the bed.
No, for real.
We found a microphone and antenna top of the gift shop roof. I could tell it was a listening device.
And 3, make sure all of this zoo stuff is just a stepping stone to launch your media career.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to JoeExoticTV.com.
Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. It's Carol at Big Cat Rescue.
There, look at me, how young I am there on Letterman. Man.
Leading this herd of cat folk is Joe Exotic, a zoo owner who looks like you hit randomize on the Fallout character creator, where even the basic facts of his life sound like the last things an AI would spit out before it crashes.
The gay gun cane redneck with a mullet.
He's locked in a life and death struggle with literal Catwoman, Carol Baskin, an animal rights activist who used to sell exotic animal cubs.
Throughout this tape, we'll show you how we take them from the mother.
And now uses the veneer of a charity to obscure the line between zoo and sanctuary, and also probably maybe sorta killed her husband.
The lady who runs Big Cat Rescue killed her own husband, potentially.
Her husband disappeared, supposedly buried in their property.
I promise you, he's underneath that septic tank.
Crazy.
Look at her eyes! She's totally lying!
So suit up for the documentary event that took the genre from true crime to holy sh**, no way that's true, crime. That was smart enough to give you just enough Joe Exotic to keep him compelling. Because as anyone in show business will tell you, never go full Joe Exotic. And marks the beginning, not the end, of the biggest thing to happen to tigers since Zoo Books. Because A-listers are rushing to play Joe. Spin-off series are already on their way. And you just know Joe Exotic is going to get pardoned by the president. I'm sure there's a job waiting for him at the EPA.
Guess what, mother f***?
Starring Joe's crack team of employees.
I'm working with people that just got out of prison.
I found this place on Craigslist.
Travis was a pothead from hell.
He kept me
sober, not drinking.
First got to the zoo, I didn't really know anything about the zoo.
I worked at the ammo section. When I got the job offer to work for Joe, I was like, what's the job? He said, campaign manager.
Meat talk.
There's only 5 buckets of meat in there.
Meat to do the wolves.
Most of the meat was from the Walmart truck.
Expired meat, and that's what they ate.
Getting interviewed while holding an animal.
I'd like to introduce my friend today.
We have tigers.
Joe supplied tigers.
We breed them.
28 species.
The guy that got killed by the lions.
That's the way it was.
Oh, little girl.
Threatening to kill people.
If somebody thinks they're gonna walk in here and take my animals away, it's gonna be a small Waco.
He was talking about dropping grenades.
You can guarantee I'm gonna put a cap in your ass.
Somebody needs to kill the bitch.
You will stop breathing.
I'll cut her f***ing head off.
And then I'm gonna put a bullet right between your f***ing eyes.
Me and Joe made a pact. If anything went bad, we were gonna shoot each other.
Going broke.
I don't own anything. This bus is not mine. Those cars are not mine.
Joe maxed out all the credit cards.
They had Joe against the ropes because he was broke.
Jeff Lowe doesn't have no money. Mom ran out of money.
It's time that somebody as broke as me and you get in there. I'm broke as
employee abuse.
He pays the staff $150 a week.
$100 a week.
I don't pay anybody to do animal care.
Animal abuse.
He puts tigers who've aged out of playtime events in a gas chamber.
Naked cubs in the hotel.
Counts 3 through 7 are for shooting and killing 5 tigers.
Fashion abuse.
How many Affliction t-shirts do you own?
60 or 70.
Carol laughing at something she just said.
He's gonna get nasty with me. Dang near shot the neighbor's dog.
I picked up the gun, held it on him.
If someone were to kill me, I think it would push this movement so far forward that it would be worth it.
Shaq patronized these people? Aw, that's a bummer. Logan Paul? Yeah, that makes sense. No! The thin line between exotic animal lover and cult leader.
They were virgins or close to virgins. If they wanted to get to the top, they should sleep with him.
He's got his little cult and I got my little cult.
The thin line between exotic animal lover and drug dealer.
Joe kept him pumped full of weed.
I sold drugs to maintain my animal habit.
Open up the snakes, stick bags of cocaine inside of them, stitch them back up.
We call it meth mouth.
The thin line between exotic animal lover and exotic animal lover.
Little gets you a lot of
Come here, you sexy beast.
You're a muddy, my sexy tiger.
Let's see your foot, sexy lawyer.
Come here, love me. Come here, love me.
And payback.
I've been doing this 20 years, never even been fit.
Bonding with them, or you have a school?
Ow, son of a bitch.
Get out, man.
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
An emergency. Got an employee that was attacked by a tiger.
The arm is completely gone. We do not have time to wait.
I'm never going to financially recover from this.
Animal crackers. When they ask how I'd like to be remembered when I'm gone, I don't have an answer except to say, not like this.
If I was sitting there concentrating as short as I could on the computer, them gummies rubbing balls in my face. They were like golden nuggets to that boy.
Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. You were good, son. Real good. Maybe even the best. Stringle-handedly achieving orchestra excellence. He's there, the Phantom of the Opera.
You always make me say the stupidest things, you guys. God!
What did you think about these honest trailers? If you enjoyed it, talk to me down below if you enjoyed my reaction. Leave a like. Tell your friends. Always come back for more. And I'll see you when I see you. Peace.